Welcome students, we are doing exercise 6.5. Today we will do question number 3, question number 4 and question number 5. Question number 3 is in figure 6.53. This figure is given. ABD is a triangle right angled at A and AC is perpendicular on BD. Show that AB square equal to VC into VD, AC square equal to VC into DC, AD square equal to VD into CD. We are given that this angle VAD is 90 degree, also AC is perpendicular on BD. Therefore, angle ACD and angle ACV both are also 90 degree. This is given and we have to prove these three parts. To prove these three parts, first of all, we have to take triangle ABD, whole triangle. ABD, this is the right triangle, and the other triangle CBA, CVA, this is also right triangle. In these triangles, angle VAD, VAD, second, first and third letter here VCA, these angles are 90 degree each. We can see that this is angle VAD 90 degree and VCA, this angle is also 90 degree. Also angle ABD, first, second, third letter here CBA, CBA, these are also equal. How ABD, this angle, and CBA, CVA, again this angle, it is common. Therefore triangle ABD becomes similar to triangle CBA by double A criterion, and this is equation number 1. After getting equation number 1, we have to take triangle ABD again, and now we have to take triangle CAD, this triangle CAD, this interior upper triangle, this is also right triangle. Angle VAD, VAD, second, first and third letter here ACD, these angles are 90 degree each. We can see VAD, VAD, this angle, and ACD, ACD, this angle, and angle VDA equal to angle ADC, this is angle VDA, VDA, and ADC, ADC, again this angle. Therefore these two angles are equal because they are common. We get triangle ABD similar to triangle CAD also. From equation 1 and 2 we can see that this triangle ABD, this whole triangle ABD, is common. Therefore we get triangle ABD similar to triangle CBA, similar to triangle CAD. All these three triangles are similar because CBA is similar to ABD and CAD also similar to ABD. It means all these three triangles are similar. This we get from question number 1 and 2. This is first part of this question. Now we have to prove these three parts. First of all, we have to get these three triangles similar. Now to prove first part, AB square equal to VC into VD, we have to take this whole triangle ABD and this triangle CBA, CVA. And to prove second part, we have to take interior triangles, triangle CBA and triangle CAD. And to prove third part, we have to take whole triangle ABD and this upper anterior triangle CAD. Let us do part first. From equation 3, we have triangle ABD is similar to triangle CBA. We have to take triangle CBA similar to triangle ABD. And now we have to use theorem of areas of similar triangle, which states that ratio of areas of similar triangle is equal to the ratio of square of corresponding sides. Therefore area of triangle CBA upon area of triangle ABD is equal to AB upon DB, because AB and DB are corresponding sides here. After this, we have to use the formula of area of triangle, which is 1 by 2 into base into altitude. And in triangle CBA, this is triangle CBA, here base is VC and altitude is AC. Therefore, we have 1 by 2 into VC into AC. And in triangle AVD, base is DV and altitude is AC. In triangle AVD, this is triangle AVD, base is VD and altitude is again AC. Now this AC cancels this AC and this DV square cancels this DV. We are left with DV only in the denominator, and this 1 by 2 cancels this 1 by 2. In the left side we have only VC, and in the right side we have AB square 1 DV. This square has been cancelled by this DV. So in the next step we will get AB square equal to DV into VC. DV into VC. This is our part. First, AB square equal to VD into VC. DV and VC are same. Therefore, we have proved our part first. Now we have to prove AC square equal to VC into DC. To prove this, we have to take interior triangles. Triangle CBA similar to triangle CAD. We have to keep in mind that to prove second part, we have to take these two interior triangles. And to prove part first, we have to take whole triangle plus this lower triangle. And to prove part third, we have to take whole triangle and this upper triangle. Both interior triangles are taken here. And we have to use theorem of areas of similar triangles. We will get area of triangle CBA upon area of triangle CAD equal to AC square upon DC square, because AC and DC are corresponding sides here. Now, as we did in part first, we'll use formula of area of a triangle, which is 1 by 2 into base into altitude, and CBA, this triangle CVA, here base is VC and altitude is AC, and in triangle CAD, base is CD or DC and altitude is AC. Altitude will be AC always. In all these three triangles, altitude is AC. And we'll cancel this AC for this AC, and this 1 by 2 for this 1 by 2, and this DC will cancel this square, and we will left with only DC in the denominator. And in the next step, we have AC square equal to VC into DC, and this is our part second. AC square equal to VC into DC, hence proved. And to prove our third, we have to take triangle, whole triangle, that is ABD, and this triangle CAD, this upper triangle CAD. By using theorem of areas of similar triangle, we have area of triangle CAD upon area of triangle ABD equal to AD upon VD, because these are corresponding sides. And area of triangle CAD is 1 by 2 into base into altitude, and the base of this triangle is CD and altitude is AC, and base of triangle ABD is VD and altitude is AC. This AC cancels this AC, 1 by 2, and this VD cancels this square, as we did in part first and part second, and we get AD square equal to VD into CD. This is part third, AD square equal to VD into CD. In this way, we have to complete this question number 3. Now, question number 4 and question number 5 are simple. Question number 4 is, ABC is an isosceles triangle right angled at C. Prove that AB square equal to 2AC square. We are given that ABC is an isosceles triangle, and it is a right triangle also, right angled at C. We have to draw this figure. This figure is not given. We have to draw a right triangle, right angled at C, and we have to keep AC equal to BC, because this is isosceles triangle, so these two sides should be equal. We are given angle C equal to 90 degree and AC equal to BC, because it is an isosceles triangle. To prove AB square equal to 2AC square, by Pythagoras theorem, in a right triangle ACB, AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square, because Pythagoras theorem states that in a right triangle, hypotenuse square is equal to the sum of squares of other two sides. Now AC and BC are equal, therefore we have written AC square for this BC square, because AC and BC are equal. We have used question number 1 here. AB square came as such, AC square also came as such, and we have written AC square for BC square, because AC and BC are equal, and we can write AC square for BC square here. Now AC square plus AC square is 2AC square, and we get what we have to prove. AB square equal to 2AC square, hence proved. Question number 5. ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC equal to VC. If AB square equal to 2AC square, prove that ABC is a right triangle. This question number 5 is converse of question number 4. Again, we are given that ABC is an isosceles triangle, and it is given that here AC and BC are equal. AC is equal to VC. Also, it is given that AB square is equal to 2AC square. We have to prove that ABC is a right triangle. We have in given AC equal to BC and AB square equal to 2AC square. We'll use these givens to prove this question, and we have to prove that triangle ABC is a right triangle. We have in given AB square equal to 2AC square. This is taken. Now 2AC square can be written as AC square plus AC square. And after this step, we'll use this question number 1, which is given AC equal to BC. This AC square came as such, and for this AC square, we can write BC square, because AC and BC are equal. Now we get AB square equal to AC square plus BC square. And by converse of Pythagoras theorem, we get triangle ACB to be a right triangle, because converse of Pythagoras theorem states that if in a triangle we get square of one side equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides, then it should be a right triangle. Therefore, we get ACB to be a right triangle, right angle that C. And if ACB is a right triangle, then ABC is also a right triangle, because these two triangles are same, only there is a difference in the order of letters. ABC and ACB are same triangles. Therefore, we get what we have to prove in this question. In this way, you have to do this question number 5.